leg, a lower body progression today, including the legs and the glutes. So I'm going to start off pretty quickly today. I want to show you all the correct techniques to use on your body with the foam roller. And I see a lot of different stuff out there. So we're going to start off with the calf. Now, if you're not really good up on your hands, you can always do this hip rolling technique. But I'm going to come up on my leg and I want you to roll inside and outside on the calf. And you're going to push down as much as you need to be a little deep in the calf. So you're going to feel it a little bit. It's not going to be painful, but it's going to be slightly, I don't even know how to say this, but slightly uncomfortable. Not super uncomfortable, but slightly uncomfortable. So once you roll all the way from the Achilles up to the back of the knees, then I want you to do cross fiber. So if you notice, good morning, I'm doing outside and inside the calf, and I'm pushing down pretty much on the deeper part of the muscle. If you want to add more, go ahead and take that leg on top, your opposite leg. We call this stacking, or I call it stacking, and you can stack and move across. So this is cross fiber, and you would go across the Achilles and progressively move all the way up the calf. And of course, you're going to do this on both sides, but I'm just going to do one side today. And then always finish off with a nice flush, and make sure that foot is really soft. You don't want to flex the foot because that changes the calf. Then I'm going to come on up, and we're going to start off on the glutes because the glutes part of that lower body. If you want to add more intensity in the glutes, you can put all your weight on one side. Be careful not to roll on the bones too much. Good morning, everybody. And then we're going to just do lower, just to the sacrum, all the way to the glutes. And again, you can go side to side. If you want to intensify even more, leg up. The lower the knee is to the roller, the more intense it will be, the higher the knee. So you want to approach it from every angle. Reset, redo it. So legs apart, weighted. You can even lift your top leg to create more weight. Now I'm going to come up and over the roller, and we're going to do the hamstring attachment. You want your butt hanging off the back of the roller so that you're right at the break between the butt and the hamstring, and you're going to pike forward, and we're going to do the crossover again, cross fiber work. And you're going to feel that it's a little bit bumpy or a little rubber bandy, and that's okay. You want to get in there because it's very tough to get those attachments. The more you bend forward, the more increased pressure you're going to feel on it. If it hurts too much, just sit more upright, or you can actually lean back, but you're going side to side. And then we're going to finish off with a hamstring roll. I don't really feel this very much because I do a lot of myofascial release. You can stack on top of that hamstring, and I'll go through these progressions maybe in the next couple of weeks with tennis balls, but you want to add a little more load. And if you notice, I'm turning in, good morning, middle and outside on my hamstring. Let's come on up. And again, we're just going to come to the side for the IT. There's three different methods to hit the IT. If you're just starting out, first of all, you want a softer roller, but you can do this side saddle position. You want to go hip to the knee. There's a lot of controversy about not rolling the ITs, but I totally believe in it because you're getting the entire muscle group on the side as well. So you're going to roll from the hip to the knee. The second level would be a crossover, and you're going to go hip to the knee as well. Good morning. And you want to change your position. So notice, I'm going to do facing down for more quad side, middle for right across that center, and then slightly up for the backside. And you're going to get some hamstring on this, which is great. Then the last position would be stacking. This is for a more advanced student, someone who's not feeling it anymore in the crossover position. And again, don't just roll back and forth in the same spot. You want to face down for some, you want to face middle for some, and you want to face up for some of the rolling. Try to move fluidly so that we get fluid in, fluid out, and you're not holding too long in one spot. That can actually aggravate the muscle. Now I'm going to flip over, and we're going to do the quadriceps. I'm going to hold the position for a moment so that you can see my torso. You're on your elbows, avoid arching the back, and all you're going to do, the same thing, is flush from the knees. Let me move that microphone. From just above the knees to the hip flexors, and you may have to walk your elbows out. Keep your abdominals pulled in. I'm going to show you a lot of different positions. So you want to start square with your legs about shoulder width apart, and then you can do pigeon toe where you turn the knees all the way in. And that's going to get the outer part of the quad. You can take one knee up and you'll get inner thigh and quad. And as you come up to the knee, you're going to lift your hips. Oop, I'm running out of time. You can bring feet together, inner thighs, spread them really, really wide. That's going to change the quad work. And then for the last one, stop the roller just above the knees, lift the hips, put the toes down, and do cross fiber just above the knees. And this is going to help avoid any pulling on the knees that might cause knee pain. Well, I am out of time today. That sure went fast. Make sure you do both sides. If you have any questions, write me, and I will see you on Monday for Resistance Monday. Have a great weekend, everybody, and happy Mother's Day.